the Cinemax Summer of 1,000 Movies winds down with movie 934. Ever have one of these days? You don't have any clean socks, the car won't start, and your arch enemy has come back from the grave? Darkman 2, The Return of Durant, next.
Cinemax Vanguard. Every Wednesday in September, Cinemax has an unusual movie. Hypnotic, sensational, and always entertaining. First off, a sophisticated retelling of the Dracula legend with the very undead Peter Fonda and David Lynch.
Can you identify the body?
There's an epic from India.
Isn't that great?
A breezy comedy crime concoction with one of those Baldwin boys.
I don't know what I'd do without you.
And an outback take on Chekhov's Uncle Vanya with Sam Neill and Greta Scacchi.
You could try dried kangaroo dung. Aborigine, you swear by it.
Four Wednesdays of very intriguing cinema, once a week, to keep you on an even keel. It's all part of Cinemax Vanguard. Every Wednesday night in September.
He's been compared to legends like James Stewart.
Really?
And it's easy to see why.
Check out the talent!
In five standout films starring Tom Hanks in September on Cinemax.
Get ready.
See how this two-time Oscar winner has grown through the years.
Now how did I get to be so important?
From comedy.
Let me entertain you, huh?
To drama.
The rumor has it I'm a very good man with a very promising future.
To heartwarming classic.
I'm not a smart man, but I know what love is.
He has that certain style everyone loves.
You rotten, dishonest bastard!
Well, almost everyone. It's a night of Totally Tom.
I like this!
Starring Tom Hanks. Thursday, September 26th, starting at 4:15 on Cinemax.
For Lily, leaving home for college was a challenge.
I'm Lily, the new roommate.
First time to L.A.?
First time anywhere, really.
But releasing her inhibitions becomes her goal when she finds a special diary, Ivy's diary.
First you cut off all your hair, and then you pierce your belly button, now you're smoking?
I can help you face your fears, and you can help me face mine.
This is some kind of contest, Lily. I don't want to compete.
Lose yourself in the moment. Alyssa Milano stars in Poison Ivy 2. This week's premiere, Friday at 8 on Cinemax. The Brothers McMullen, a film that takes a humorous look at the lives and loves of three Irish Catholic brothers.
Listen, lover boy, all right, we're not on Oprah. Talking about me and my emotions, all right?
The film's off-screen story is also a heartwarming tale of family bonding for first-time writer-director Ed Burns. With Dad raising the cash as executive producer and Mom cooking for the cast and crew, The Brothers McMullen became a true labor of love for the Burns family.
I wanted to make a film that I know that I would want to go see and that my friends would want to go see. I wanted to make a film about Irish Americans because I don't think I'd ever seen one.
I'm telling you, Jack, she was beautiful.
And she didn't fall for your phony Irish charm, huh?
And I wanted to make a film about brothers that showed guys in their 20s who A, weren't like slacker, loser types, and B, weren't running around with guns acting like tough guys.
You don't believe in true love?
How the hell did a fruitcake like you end up as my brother?
Beyond the screen, the film was a hit with the critics, winning last year's Grand Jury Prize and Robert Redford's praises at the Sundance Film Festival.
You know, came up to me and told me how much he liked the film. I don't think I heard really a word he said because I was just, you know, shocked that, you know, standing there next to Robert Redford.
Proving that hit films don't always have big price tags, Ed brought the movie in for $25,000, and to date it's grossed more than $10 million, making it the most profitable film of 1995. Not bad for a guy who started out as a gopher on Entertainment Tonight.
You don't need a pile of dough. You just need a camera, a decent script, and some actors. And that's really what we did.
And speaking of cost-effective, Ed's family home was also the film's main location, where Mr. and Mrs. Burns lived during the filming.
They were very cooperative. I mean, we were there for 8 months, every weekend for 8 months, you know, shooting in their backyard and on their front lawn and, you know, in the dining room. So they kind of always kept, or would try to keep one step ahead of us, you know.
You can keep up with Ed Burns because his new film, She's the One, is in theaters right now. But first, take a look at Family, Irish American style, with the Brothers McMullen.
Another Friday premiere, September 27th at 8 on Cinemax.
The the Cinemax Summer of 1,000 Movies winds down with movie 934. Ever have one of these days? You don't have any clean socks, the car won't start, and your arch enemy has come back from the grave. Dark Man 2, The Return of Durant, next.
He was an ordinary guy, just doing his job, until one night...
Just give me that $50 tip, I'd be on my way.
A slight misunderstanding...
What's cooking?
Put your hands up, Grabowski!
...turned him into a wanted criminal.
We got a fugitive on the loose! He's armed! He is dangerous!
Yeah, I'm gonna run you over!
Now, he's on the lam with a few unsuspecting companions.
How come you didn't bring a pack, sir?
I did bring a pack. In fact, I brought two.
But before he can clear his name, he'll have to face the biggest obstacle of all, the great outdoors.
They're eating me alive!
Try my bug repellent.
Ah, good. Daniel Stern is bushwhacked.
Boy, I feel good!
Another Friday premiere, September 20th, on Cinemax.
Business is booming.
Mr. Tasker's office.
Hi, it's Helen. Is he in?
Harry's in a sales meeting, Mrs. Tasker.
Harry forgot something back at the office.
Arnold Schwarzenegger. Jamie Lee Curtis.
What were you doing there?
What can I say? I'm a spy.
True Lies.
Monday comedy at 8, September 16th on Cinemax.
I'm the idiot, you're the screw-up, and we are all losers.
Five friends have one day.
I wish they could be brave.
You are brave.
To decide what to do with the rest of their lives.
You're gonna be fine.
That is so sweet, I think I'm gonna barf.
Anthony LaPaglia and Liv Tyler.
Rock and roll.
With music from the Cranberries, the Gin Blossoms, and Toad the Wet Sprocket.
So do I get the job?
Empire Records. Another Friday premiere. Coming in October on Cinemax.
It's never been seen before in theaters or on home video. But you can find the premiere of Jade, the director's cut, this month on Cinemax. And now, Max zooms in on the man who made it. Director William Friedkin.
With Jade, I just decided to put in everything I took out of the theatrical version. What happens with the MPAA is that they say, oh, geez, you can't take this scene any further than this point, unless you want to get an X rating. And, an X rating is equivalent to censorship. People are very hypocritical about their sexual needs and sexual drives. And one of the things that attracted me to this material was Linda Fiorentino's character.
How could you let them do this to you?
They didn't do anything to me, David. It was my choice. I liked it. I was in control.
A lot of filmmakers give up the whole process of having shaped a film for the theater, and you now just let it all hang out for television.
But before Linda Fiorentino, it was Sonny and Cher who let it all hang out in Friedkin's first film, Good Times.
Still want to make a movie?
When you guys run this film on Cinemax, you should do it with a voice that comes on first saying, it's back.
Good Times is back on Cinemax this month, along with Friedkin's Academy Award-winning The French Connection.
We drove 90 miles an hour with no traffic control, ran red lights. All those cars that you see narrowly missing, Hackman's car, those are not stunt drivers. Those are actual pedestrians. And I must say, thank God, that, you know, no one got hurt. No one even got a twisted ankle on the film. But then I thought with Jade, it might be interesting to do something where there was nothing but impediments in the way of both cars. Chinatown is a very important intrinsic part of the culture of San Francisco, and I thought it would be really marvelous and colorful to put this chase in the middle of this incredible phantasmagoria of people and floats and color. The really good filmmakers eat, breathe, and sleep film. It's not a job. It's a passion. It's a way of life.
Okay, that's the cut.
And there's plenty of passion in Jade, the director's cut. This month on Cinemax.
The Cinemax Summer of 1,000 Movies winds down with movie 934. Ever have one of these days? You don't have any clean socks, the car won't start, and your arch enemy has come back from the grave? Dark Man 2, The Return of Durant, next.
At the gates of heaven, only those who repent shall be saved.
Bless me, Father, for I have just killed quite a few men.
No shit.
Antonio Banderas stars in Desperado. Another Friday premiere, coming in October on Cinemax.
When the United States government...
I got a leak in my office and a bunch of dead agents.
...doesn't know who to trust...
Most problems have very simple solutions.
It's up to one man...
He's an A1 priority.
...to go deep undercover.
He's going inside of a prison. I'm the only one who knows he's going to be in there.
But when friends...
What makes you think that you can trust me with whatever the hell it is you're doing here?
...become enemies.
Not who you think I am.
The mission...
What the hell's going on there?
10 times bigger than we ever thought.
Becomes suicide.
I never thought it would go this far.
And the trail.
He's close. He knows it.
That leads to the money.
Get me out of here, Chief.
Turns from green.
I'm gonna kill him.
To red. Anthony LaPaglia.
Pull Willie out or I'm going over your head.
Kevin Pollak.
It's no longer our decision. It's the CIA's.
Chameleon. Another Friday premiere, coming in October on Cinemax.
If Cinemax's Summer of 1,000 Movies is an entertainment freeway, then Sunday around midnight, we take you off-road. For some films you may have missed, but are definitely must-see. If it's out there, Barbarella! It's right here. In September, Cinemax brings you 5 nights of pure cult horror, beginning with Roger Corman's mini-masterpiece of economical filmmaking. Then join Jack and Boris for a movie that some people say was shot in only 3 days.
Yes.
Also, check this one out, and you'll see why two actors in one body make one hell of a flick.
Help! Shut up!
Next on the list is Andy Warhol's celebrated...
Intelligently created.
...twisted vision of reconstructive surgery. And finally, an atmospheric chilling tale inspired by Edgar Allan Poe.
Well, it looks cursed. I'll give it that.
Sunday around midnight cult horror. It's this month, and it's on Cinemax.
Don't stop now!
The following movie is rated R.